Hi everyone, in this video I'll be doing Cambridge IGCSE ICT paper 3 for the year June 2019. The variant is 3.2. In this video I'll be doing the web page task. So you can see task 1 evidence document. Let's prepare the evidence document. This is the evidence document which is given. Enter your name, center number and candidate number so that they will appear on every page. Save this as a word process document in your area with file name, evidence followed by your candidate number. So insert the header. Name, candidate number and center number. Let us save this as a Word document. Save as. It must be saved as Word document followed by your candidate number. Part of a web page is designed to look like this. You can see the part of the page. There are three items of ordered list or a numbered list, and under one of them there is a bulleted list. A trainee has attempted to create this using the HTML. This is the code given by the trainee, this code for the list. Analyze this HTML and suggest amendments. Identify where each of these amendments must be placed. So let's make changes to this. So copy this code to your evidence document. This is evidence 1. So you can see this cloud storage is an item of ordered list or a numbered list. So we should start an ordered list here, OL, and it will end after this. Now these three points are ordered, unordered list or bulleted list under this one. So after this we have to give a UL, which is unordered list, and a slash UL. So these are the changes which we made. I'll highlight them. So these are the changes which you have to make for the code. Next part, complete each sentences with the name of the web development layer. Place your answers in your evidence document. First one, the dash layer is used by scripting languages. The scripting languages are given in the behavior layer. So let's give the answer here. It is given in the behavior layer. Next one, dash layer is used for hyperlink to open a word process document. So the hyperlinks are always presented in the content layer or the structure of the web page. Next one, the dash layer is used for the markup language. So in order to set the markup language like H1, H2 and all, we use the content layer. So these two are content layers. Last one, the dash layer is used to apply styles to all web pages in a website. So all styles are used in the style sheet, and style sheet is related to presentation layer. So let's give the layer here. Content. Third one is also content. And last one is related to the styles to, it should be presentation layer. So that is evidence 2. Next one, task 2, web page. You're going to create a web page and edit a style sheet for Super Disc sales. Many of the people who will view the web page have very slow internet connection. The web page and style sheet must work in any browser. Create a new folder called SDS-HTML. So this is the folder. Create a new folder called SDS-HTML. We have to move these three files to the folder. So these are the files. Move them to this folder. Open the file sdsdisk.jpg in a suitable application. Reflect the image horizontally. So let us open this in paint.net. Right click, open with paint.net. You can also use Photoshop if paint.net is not available. So it is opened in paint.net. Now the first question is, reflect this image horizontally. So let's reflect this horizontally. Go to image, flip horizontal. So that is done. After reflecting the image horizontally, you have to save this image as disk 1 in your folder. So let's save this file. Save as, this must be saved as disk 1 and JPG file. Make sure it is inside your folder. Save. Rotate this image 90 degree clockwise and save this as disk 2. So go to image, rotate 90 degree clockwise. And this must be saved as disk 2. Disk 2, it is saved. Crop the image disk 2 so that all the solid state drive is visible with an equal amount of red background on each side. This image must be a square. Do not distort the image. The hard disk must not be visible. So we need to only crop out the solid state drive, which should be in a square shape. So we need only this part. So in order to crop it, first we have to select the required area. So for that, click on the selection tool here. This is the selection tool. And then we have to go to the selection mode, in which this should be set to fixed ratio, because we need a square. So fixed ratio, give 1:1, because we need a square shape. 1:1 I'm giving. Now we'll select it so that it will be a square shape. Select in such a way that almost all sides have equal red area. This is almost okay. So select it. Now you can go to image, crop to selection. So we got the image in square shape. Save this image as disk 3. File, save as disk 3. Resize the image disk 3 to become 600 by 600 pixels. Save this as disk 4. Go to image, resize. It must be 600 pixels. 600. Width and height must be 600. Give OK. Save this as disk 4. Save as disk 4. So now the image is saved. Display the contents of your folder showing the folder name, image dimensions, all file names, file extensions and file sizes. So this is your folder. So right click here and then go to view, give the option content, so that all the details will be shown here. Now you have to take the screenshot. When you are taking the screenshot, make sure your folder name is also taken. This will show all the details of all the files stored in this folder. That is your evidence 3. Next, create a web page called solidstatedrive.htm. So go to web expression, open a new file, new HTML file, because it's a web page. We have to save this as, save as. Inside your SDS HTML folder, you must save it as solid state drive. That is the name, solid state drive. You can save it. Save. This web page must work in all browsers and will have a table structure as shown here. So you can see here there are 3 rows and 3 columns for this table. So let's insert a table. 3 rows and 3 columns. You can see the first 3 cells are merged here. So these 3 are merged. Right click, modify, merge cells. Next we have these 2 cells merged. So the first 2 cells are merged. Right click, modify, merge cells. Now let's give the dimensions. The first row is 1400 by 80. Right click, cell properties, it must be 1400 by 80. Give OK. This row must be 800 by 600 and this is 600 by 600. Modify. Sorry, cell properties. 800 by 600. Give OK. And this cell is 600 by 600. Go to cell properties. 600 by 600. And the last 3 cells, it is 400 by 80. Cell properties, 400 by 80. Each table is identified with a letter and all dimensions are in pixel. The letters must not be shown. Table borders and grid lines must appear on the final web page. We have to make sure the grid lines come when you are showing the web page. Enter in cell A the text SSDs from Super Disk Sales. Cell A means this one. Before starting to do this, we have to go to the table properties, remove the width of the table, because the width and height of each cell is already specified. So we should not give the width of the table. If you set it as 100, it will always take up the 100% of the window. So you have to remove this. Give OK. Now this is cell A. In this cell, we have to type the text SSDs from Super Disk Sales, and it must be set to style H1. So you can click here and set the style H1. Next one, place in cell B the text from the file ssd.txt. So ssd.txt is shown here. You have to copy this data. So select all, control A, copy, and it must be pasted into cell B. B means this cell. Paste it here. Set this text as style H2. Select this and then give the style h2. Place in cell C the image disk4.jpg. So here you can insert the image. Keep your cursor here. Go to insert picture from file. Disk 4. This is your disk 4. And give the alternate text ask. It's an SSD. So you can give SSD. So we already gave the alternate text. Enter in cell D, home page. This must be set to style H3. Cell D means this cell. This is the cell in which we have to type home page. So type here home page and set it as H3. Select and set it as H3. Next, in cell E, we have to type contact us and set it as H3 again. This must be H3. Make this text a hyperlink to open an email editor ready to send a message to sds@cambridgeinternational.org with this subject line. So select this, right click, hyperlink. We need an email message, so click on email address. Type the email ID here. This is the email ID. Subject is SSD inquiry. Give OK. Next, we have to give web page edited by, that also in style H3. Type your name, candidate number, and center number. This must be in style H3. Next, attach the style sheet ssdstyle.css to this web page and save your web page. So you can see here attach style sheet. Click on attach style sheet. Select the style sheet and give OK. So the style sheet is attached. Open the style sheet SSD in a suitable software package. Edit the style sheet to meet these specifications. So let's open the style sheet. Save this file. Open. This is the style sheet. Now we have to edit this. So in order to edit, you can see H1, H2, H3 here. Right click, modify style. Now we have to add this. Arial, if not available, Helvetica or any sans serif font. That is already given here. Next one, font color set to hexadecimal 361215. So let's set the font color. Click here. 36. First component is 36. Then 12 and 15. Give OK. Alignment is center. So alignment you can find in block. Text align, center. So all the styles for H1, H2, H3 is done. Give OK. So it is amended now. Now we can give the other styles. H1 is 30 points. Format, new style. H1, it must be 30 point. So 30. Font size must be 30 point. Make sure it is PT. Give okay. Next style. H2. H2 must be 14 and H3 must be 20. 14 points, all are points. So make sure it is PT here. Okay. For H3, it is 20. All table cells, padding set to 15 pixels. So table cells are defined by the style TD. So go to format, new style. Let's type here TD. You can find the padding in box and it is 15 pixels. So just type here 15 px, it's same for all. Give OK. Next we have to give the no collapse borders for table. Let's go to table style. In table, border collapse, no collapse means we have to give separate. So give separate. In table, the style name is table, and in the table category, go for border collapse, it is separate. Okay. And the last one, background color, blue component set to 99 and FF for both red and green. Blue is 99 and FF is for both red and green. So background color is defined in the style body. Body, background color, blue is 99 and red and green is FF. So RGB, blue is 99, red is FF and green is also FF. Give OK. We have given all the styles specified here. In the beginning of the page, they had told the table borders and grid lines must appear on the final web page. So let's give the code for that. Go to format, new style. We can give table, comma, TD. Because both external and internal grid lines, and go to border and border style, you can set it as solid so that it will be visible. Give OK. Next, add your name, center number and candidate number as a comment at the bottom of the style sheet. So in order to add the comment slash star, then give your name, candidate number and center number, then star slash. So this is how you write a comment. Save this style sheet in your folder. So let's save this style sheet. Display your style sheet in your software package. Take a screenshot showing the content of your style sheet and place this in your evidence document. So let's take the screenshot for this. This is the style sheet. Take the screenshot and place this in your evidence document, that is evidence 4. Next, display the web page in your browser. If necessary, resize it so that all page can be seen, all text can be easily read, and the address bar is visible. So this is your web page. Let's display in the browser. File, preview in browser. So this is the web page. You have to take screenshot of this. Make sure the address bar is also visible. That is evidence 5. Display the HTML source in your editor and place this in your evidence document. So the HTML sources, click on code, you can find the HTML code. Copy this, Control A. Copy this and paste it in your evidence document as evidence 6. Save your evidence and print it. Save your evidence document. So this is the end of the web page task. Next one is the spreadsheet. It has been already done and uploaded. You can find the link in the description. Thank you.